Bonjour et bienvenue.
Hello and welcome to Africa News. Our guest today is the Prime Minister of Congo, Anatole Coligny Makoso. He joins us from Brazzaville, the Congolese capital. Mr. Prime Minister, thank you for being with us.
Merci d'être avec nous.
Bonjour.
Hello.
The country is heavily indebted. The public debt amounts to more than $10 billion. This represents 98% of the GDP. Your government wants to reduce this figure to 70%. How do you plan to get there and within what time frame?
It is true that the level of debt is estimated today at 98% of GDP, as you say. But I would like to remind you that a few months ago, against the backdrop of media escalation, it was announced that it was above 110%. And today, if we have reached 98%, that means that we have made a lot of efforts internally. And we are counting on the program with the IMF, with whom we will relaunch our negotiations.
Have you set a deadline to reach this 70%?
Everything depends on relations. Everything depends on the level of negotiations with our partners. But we think that in 2 years, we can start to see the end of the tunnel.
In 2019, Congo reached an agreement with the IMF to obtain aid of nearly $450 million. A part of this sum was immediately disbursed, and since then, nothing. Do you think the IMF is wary of Congo?
We do not know if the IMF is suspicious of the Congo. We have simply noted that they have justified the reluctance regarding support for our country, which is still in debt, and they have asked us for restructuring. But Congo is still fighting. We're working to be resilient in the face of this pandemic, and we are doing quite well.
Congo is having great difficulty paying back its debt to its main creditor, which is China. Beijing has once again agreed to restructure the country's debt, more than $2 billion. Will this situation push Congo to learn the lessons of its dependence on Chinese loans?
This relationship with China has enabled us to carry out major infrastructure work in our country. This is the proof, and we have been frank about it. We are sincere, and this is a win-win cooperation with China.
Are you sure that this cooperation with China is a win-win situation?
Well, going by the efforts that have been made in the development of infrastructures, in the revival of the economy, you will realize that we are not losers either.
During your general policy speech to the National Assembly, you talked about many topics, but not about political prisoners and imprisoned activists. Was this intentional, or will this issue be addressed by a government?
I don't think we have political prisoners in our country, madam.
I think...
No. I don't think that we've got any. We have compatriots who have been prosecuted, tried, and sentenced. If that's what you call political prisoners, that's up to you. Now, for those who have not yet been tried, they only want one thing, that the procedure be accelerated to allow them to reassert their rights of defense.
Anatole Coligny Makoso, Prime Minister of Congo, thank you very much for sharing your insights on African News.
Thank you as well, madam.
Thank you for watching this interview. Stay tuned on African News for more information across the African continent.